Hello again, this is Colin Gomel. In this tutorial, I'd like to focus on the subject of default parameters. I've chosen an example, a function called printit, which takes a single parameter of type string. I've called the parameter message, and all the function does is output the message followed by a new line. So it literally prints the message followed by a new line. It's a very simple function in that regard. However, up here in the function prototype, instead of just writing string message, I've written equals hello world. And so we can see that when I run this program, which I'll do now, I'll compile and run the program, the first time it says hello from Colin, and the second time it says hello world. Let's enter Q to quit and take a look at that. The first invocation of the function printit passes an actual parameter of the string hello from Colin. So naturally, printit prints the string hello from Colin. The interesting thing is, what happens if I just call the function printit with no actual parameters? In this case, C++, seeing no parameters, goes to the function prototype and picks up the default definition of that parameter. In this case, it takes the default string hello world, which is declared in the function prototype, as I said, and uses that value as the value of the string message. In its simplest form, that's really all there is to default parameters. The syntax is a little weird. Notice that the initialization must appear in the function prototype. It's not valid in C++ for the initialization to appear in the function definition down here. So the correct syntax is the initialization equals hello world appears in the function prototype at the beginning of your program. Thank you.